Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
We were somewhere around Barstow, on the edge of the desert, when the buzz began to take hold. I remember saying something like,
"I feel a bit lightheaded. Maybe you should drive."
But the thing is, I was the only one in the car. And suddenly there was a terrible roar all around me, and everything was full of what looked like Pokemon, all dancing and popping up around the car. On the way to Las Vegas, the vibrations were getting nasty. But why? Was there no communication in this car? Had I deteriorated to the level of a dumb beast? Bad waves of paranoia, madness, fear and loathing, intolerable vibrations. It was almost noon, and I still had more than 100 miles to go. They would be tough miles. Very soon I knew I would be completely twisted. But there was no going back, and no time to rest. I would have to ride it out. It was my birthday, and I was going to Vegas. Anything could happen. But this trip was different. It was a classic affirmation of everything right and true and decent in the national character. It was a gross physical salute to the fantastic possibilities of life in this country, but only for those with true grit, and I was chock full of that. The car suddenly veered off the road, and I remembered,
"What? We can't stop here! This is Pokemon country!"
My family and friends had given me $50 in cash, most of which was already spent on extremely potent substances. The trunk of the car looked like a mobile Willy Wonka candy convention. There were 2 bags of Warheads, 25 individual sour straws, 2 packets of high-powered gummy bears, a box half full of Nerds, and a whole galaxy of Sour Skittles, Sweethearts, Shockers, Rice Krispies, and also a can of NOS that I had already finished, a quart of grape drink, a case of soda, a pack of raw Fun Dip, and 5-hour energy shots. All this had been rounded up the night before, in a frenzy of high-speed driving all over Los Angeles County. Not that I needed all that for the trip, but once you get locked into a serious candy collection, the tendency is to push it as far as you can. The only thing that worried me was the Fun Dip. There is nothing in the world more helpless and irresponsible and depraved than a man in the depths of a Fun Dip fix. And I knew I'd get into that rotten stuff pretty soon. But what was the story? Nobody bothered to say. I was trying to figure it all out. I kept having flashbacks of Vegas. 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 So we would have to drum it up on our own. Free enterprise, the American dream, Horatio Alger gone mad on sugar, in Las Vegas. Do it now, pure birthday shenanigans. There was also the socio-psychic factor. Every now and then I couldn't tell the difference between real life or Vegas. It was my birthday, and every now and then when your life gets complicated and the weasels start closing in, the only real cure is to load up on heinous sugars and then drive like a bastard from Hollywood to Las Vegas. Las Vegas, a town full of bedrock crazies. Nobody even notices a candy kook.